Hi guys, in this video, I'm going to talk about SAP eCATT. In this video, we're going to cover what is eCATT, what can we do with SAP eCATT, when to use eCATT, and what are the real-time examples for SAP eCATT, what are the components of SAP eCATT, what are the prerequisites to use SAP eCATT, and we'll try to cover some of the eCATT commands, and at the end, we'll try to cover what are the do's and don'ts of using SAP eCATT. Let's begin. What is SAP eCATT? eCATT stands for Extended Computer Aided Test Tool. It is a test automation tool provided by SAP. By using SAP eCATT, you can create, execute, manage, automate tests. By using SAP eCATT, you can actually test SAP applications and SAP business processes. By using SAP eCATT, you can actually record test cases and you can always play back the tests whenever you want. What can we do with SAP eCATT? With SAP eCATT, you can execute functional tests to test SAP business processes end-to-end. By using SAP eCATT, you can test SAP transactions, reports, scenarios, remote systems, authorizations, updates, customizing settings, and system messages. Within SAP eCATT scripts, you can call BAPIs, function modules, and external tools like QTP. Once you execute any SAP eCATT test, it will generate log files where you can see the log of entire SAP test case execution. Let's now talk about when to use SAP eCATT. You can use SAP eCATT when you want to do regression testing, data migration, integration testing, load testing, business process testing, automate SAP GUI for Windows testing, WebDAM Pro for ABAP testing, and you can also test OData services by using eCATT. By using eCATT, you can also schedule tests hourly, daily, or monthly based on the business requirement. For example, you can use SAP eCATT for purchase order creation, employee onboarding, inventory management. In case of purchase order creation, to test the end-to-end business process, first you execute create purchase order transaction, then you do the verification after the PO creation. Similarly, for employee onboarding, you can actually automate onboarding process like user creation, role assignment, data validation. Similarly, for inventory management, from goods receipt to stock transfer, end-to-end automation that can be performed by using SAP eCATT. What are the components of SAP eCATT? In SAP eCATT, we have something called test configuration. This test configuration holds all of your SAP eCATT testing objects. Then we have something called System Data Container. What is System Data Container? It is a container which holds information about your SAP systems. For example, System Data Container typically contains information about dev systems, quality systems, and validation systems. System Data Container actually provides the information about the systems on which these SAP eCATT tests need to be executed. Then we create something called Test Script. What is test script? In SAP eCATT, test script actually takes care of executing the tests. In SAP eCATT test scripts, we have some commands. We have something called TCD, RFC, DBRead. We have different types of commands based on your purpose. You have to use set of commands to perform the testing execution. Finally, we have something called test data container. What is a test data container? Test data container holds the data sets for your testing. For example, if you want to test a transaction, in test data container, you can create different types of data sets. By using these data sets, you can execute different types of sets by using the same script. For example, you can create one data set for development, other one for quality. By using different data sets, you can execute same script and test in two different systems. So just to recap, in SAP eCATT, we have test configuration, System Data Container, Test Script, and Test Data Container. What are the prerequisites to use SAP eCATT? To use SAP eCATT, you should have a SAP system which is running on Web Application Server 6.2 or higher. The second thing is, you have to enable scripting on SAP system. To enable scripting, you need to contact your SAP basis team. And the last thing is, you have to have authorizations to SAP eCATT. If you don't have access to SAP eCATT transaction, please reach out to your authorizations team. Let's now talk about some of the eCATT commands that you can use in SAP eCATT scripting. For example, you can use TCD to record the transactions. You can use RFC command to invoke the remote function calls. You can use loop command to iterate the steps in SAP script. You can use dbread to read the data from database. You can use log command to log the entries to the log. Similarly, we have commands like if else, dbcheck, dbupdate, dbdelete, and gui. And there are many more commands. Please read SAP help documentation to get to know about more commands. Let's now talk about do's and don'ts of using SAP eCATT. Always, you need to check the prerequisites before using SAP eCATT. And you need to make sure you use the right driver for SAP GUI for Windows, Java, and HTML. When you want to integrate external testing tool with SAP eCATT, you need to make sure the external testing tool is certified by SAP. Under don'ts, by using SAP eCATT, the first thing you need to remember is, should never run test scripts on production system. Do not use SAP eCATT to test applications that are not supported by SAP control framework. Finally, I would like to share with you one document that I created long back, which elaborates how to create test scripts in SAP eCATT. The link is in the description. Please download the document and practice SAP eCATT scripting. Hope you learned something from this video. If you like the video, consider giving a like, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.